A very warm welcome to Computer Science by Times. Today we'll be doing practical of chapter 12, MySQL revision 2. Okay, so here we are doing the practical. So firstly, we must know MySQL is a case insensitive language, so it hardly matters whether we are writing in uppercase, whether we are writing in lowercase, it will not make any difference. So firstly, we need to create database inside MySQL, and how to create it? For that we need to write a command. What will be the command? Create database. Okay, and I am naming it A. Fine, ABC, let us say ABC. Fine, my database name is ABC. See, your database has been created. So now we will create a table, but before that we need to enter inside this database. How to enter inside? For that you should write use ABC. Fine, in this way you will be able to enter inside this database. Okay, now you can see your database has been changed. Whatever the previous database was, now your database is ABC. Now we'll create a table here. How to create a table? For that the command is always be vigilant, your spellings, they should be correct. If the spellings are not correct, spacing is not proper, then your results will be wrong. Otherwise SQL is very easy to use and execute. So for that, create table. I will use student table. So my name of table is student. So firstly, I am describing the structure of this table, how to define it. You need to use this command create table student and use this round brackets, and now define the number of columns along with their data types separated by a comma. Fine, in this way you can let me do the practical part of it. I will be making three fields. First will be your roll number. Fine, and what will be the data type? I will take it integer. We have discussed the data type yesterday, na? So now second column I'll be making of your names. Okay, name, and I'll be taking data type varchar or char, both are okay. So I'm taking 20 size of it. It will allow me to enter a particular name up to 20 spaces or 20 characters, I must say. Okay, now third is percentage. Let me write it completely, and its data type I'll be taking integer again. You can use float also, there is no problem. You can use decimal also, you can use double also. See, it's totally dependent upon your requirement. Fine, why we are putting this semicolon every time? Because semicolon is indicating the end or the termination of the particular statement or the instruction. As we use full stop in English to terminate a sentence, and in Hindi we use Puran Viram to terminate. Similarly, in MySQL we use semicolon to terminate a particular instruction. Fine. Now, when I'll be putting enter, you can see one row has been, actually structure of the table has been created. We want to see the structure. How to see it? DESC, that is describe. Describe what? Student. Student is the name of my table. Okay, mind it, the spelling should be right every time. Okay, so you can see a table has been created whose name is student, and it is having three columns: rows, roll number, name and percentage, and these are the data types that we have defined. Fine, now what we will do? Now we'll add data inside these table. Okay, how to add data inside the table? For that we must use command insert. Fine, insert what? Insert into should not be missed out. Insert into what? Student table. Okay, insert into student, and for that again you must use a word values. insert into student values. Now use the bracket. Okay, now we must enter the values in the same order. Firstly, we must write roll number, then name, and then percentage. We cannot change the order. If we will try to change it here, then it will enter this data in a wrong fashion. Okay, fine. But means whatever value you will write first will go in roll number, whatever you will be writing second will go in name, and third value will go in percentage. So you must follow the same order. Okay, now I'm entering roll number is 1 and name is like say Ram. So whatever string you are writing means it can be entered with the help of single quotes or double quotes. See, Ram is written in double, it may be written in single quotes, both are correct. Okay, percentage, like suppose he has scored 98, so I am putting a semicolon to terminate it. One row affected, it shows what that this row has been added to the table student. Okay, now what we will do, we will try to see whether this particular row has been inserted or not. So select space star from student, fine. Now I'll put a semicolon, enter. Now you can see my table has been created and it is having one row inside it, and the data is also there, fine. Now instead of writing the same line again and again, because every time I will try to add a particular row inside this table, for that I need to write this command again and again, but I just don't want to write it similar command again and again. In order to avoid it, what I will do, I will use this upper arrow key. Okay, it will give me all the commands previously that I have written. Similar command was written previously also, so with the help of these arrow keys only and backspace also, I will modify it. And now I'll tell you how to enter more than one command, more than one value in a table at a time. Okay, now my second name of the candidate is Shyam, and he has also scored, let us say, 98%. Now I just want to add two more. His roll number is 3 and his name is, say, John. Okay, and he has scored 89%. Always write the character part in single quotes or double quotes. I'll show you, if you are using single quotes also, then it will not create any problem. Okay, Geet, I'm using single quotes here, you see this will not create any problem, and he has scored 67%. Now I'll put semicolon. You see three rows are added in this particular table. I just want to check it. How to check it? Select star from student. You can see now we have 4 number of rows inside this table, fine. There are other methods also. If see, it is compulsory to add 3 values together for a row. Why 3? Because we have created 3 columns na, that is why I am saying 3 together. If we don't want to add 3, then there is a method with the help of which we can avoid writing value of any of the column. Okay, there are 2 methods I'll be discussing one by one. First is, let us say a child name is Meera and he has not given exams, fine. He has not given exams, so we can't calculate percentage, so we will keep it null. Okay, but how to enter? See, if you will not give values of Meera percentage here in the table, it will generate error. See, I'll show you like this. I'm entering a new record here and I will not enter this percentage of Meera. What I'll do, M Meera. Okay, she's a new student and her roll number is 5. See, this will generate an error. Why? Because third column we have not given. Okay, and if we want to skip this particular problem, then what is to be done? Either you give comma and null, means she has not given exam, so she has not scored anything. See, now the row has been created. You want to see whether it has been created? See, it has been created, but the percentage has not been entered. Now let us say I want to enter this student, like another student is there, Geeta, and she has also not given exams. She was a new student. So how to do this without giving this marks entry? You don't want to give marks of Geeta. Name is Geeta. Okay, now I don't want to enter the marks. So what I should do? I should write name of the fields here where these two values should go. Okay, these two values should go where. So I'll be writing here the name is roll number comma, and second value should go in name. Fine. So I'll put, now it will be fine. See, roll number will have one value. Actually, I must change roll number also, because she is a new student, her roll number would be 6. Fine. Okay, now if I'll put enter, it will be acceptable. See, it is acceptable. You want to see it whether it has been added or not? See, Geeta has been added, but no percentage is entered. Okay, I hope this concept is clear to all of you. Okay, what can be the next command? Next can be to use where. Okay, so how to use where? Okay, select for that also, again select. Now I want to take names of those students who have scored greater than 90%. Okay, so you can see more than 90 Ram and Shyam are there. So this would be my outcome. But how this outcome would be obtained? Select name, to only names will come. Okay, so I'm just taking names, select name from student. Okay, select name from student where percentage is greater than, I must say, 90. Okay, select name from student where percentage is 90. Okay, you got answer Ram and Shyam. I hope it is clear. So this way you can put condition. See, along with it, I just want to have name ke saath, I just want to have roll number also. So how to write it? Roll number comma name. Okay, so what will be the outcome? Name, roll number will also come. Okay, now usage of or. Fine, so how to use it? Where percentage is 90 or greater than 90, or what I must say, percentage is equal to 67, so Geet will also come. Okay, from the above table I have selected it. Geet has scored 67. Either percentage will be greater than 90 or it will be 67. So see outcome. Okay, I hope it is clear. Or means if this is satisfied or this is satisfied, the both results will come together. Okay, or means either this will be okay, then condition following, I mean the rows following this instruction will come, or if this is okay, then rows following this condition will appear in the output. Okay.